finding a clump of sassafras leaves alerts me to the fact that there are some sassafras trees nearby. So now I know I'll keep a lookout for them because this is one of my very favorite herbs to harvest at this time of year. Here's my beloved sassafras tree. This is another native tree, actually, in our area. This is a rather small tree, and they do grow much, much taller. Sometimes the sassafras trees are 40 feet tall. She makes it easy for us to identify by having three different shaped leaves on the same tree. You have this shaped leaf, from which she gets her nickname, the mitten tree. You have the more solid whole leaf, right, like that, kind of oval shaped. And then you have the triple lobed leaf. So all three of these appear on the tree at the same time. And though it's the root of sassafras that has traditionally been used as medicine for years and years, I use almost no sassafras root and really wait for the autumn to use the leaves. I'll gather a few green leaves, and mostly I actually wait until the leaves are turning colors. They're yellow and they're orange and they're rust colored, and they are ready to fall to the ground. Sometimes I even pick them up from the ground so the tree doesn't need them anymore. And they still make a wonderful sassafras medicine. And sassafras medicine is uplifting to the spirit, is helpful for congestion in the lymph system, generally will make you laugh and smile, really, many other things. Clears the skin, it's useful for coughs, for dry coughs, and I find that for people who suffer with the lack of light in the winter, having some sassafras leaf infusion in their diet over the winter can make a real difference in their happiness in getting through the winter season. I'm very grateful to the sassafras tree, and this is one that I make absolutely sure to get a really big bag of leaves in the autumn time to get me through to the spring. Even though her classic reputation is as a spring tonic, I love her as a spring tonic, but I rely on her as a fall tonic.